We'll start our cab ride at the grain facility, where a pair of Atlas Gensets makes up our train of loaded grain hoppers. These units in real life are very quiet, and the models are no exception, so you won't hear a lot of noise from them, but every now and then you will hear the prime movers starting and stopping as the engineer notches up and down the throttle. Switching cars is probably the only thing in model railroading that actually is the same time and scale as the real thing. And if you go about it in a reasonable speed, it can take quite a while to switch out a train. With our train finally made up, it's time to wait for the clear signal and hit the main line. These gensets usually spend their lives switching West Birdwood Yard, so I thought it'd be a good idea to get them on the main and stretch their legs for a little bit. I've used three cameras to get these shots. I've used my big Sony HXR NX3 and iPhone and my Drift POV camera, which is our cab ride car. Thank you. Now, this area through this cutting is where I really need to hone my plaster carving and rock skills. I don't have a lot of room here for plaster molds, so all the rocks will have to be free-formed. So I'm waiting to do this till my skill levels increase a lot, because it'd be a nice little scene through here. We're passing under the helix now, and it's a shot you don't normally see. The helix is 38 inch or 2 metre diameter and a 1.8% grade. We're stopping here for a meet with our ethanol train. Thank you. The signals that you see on the layout are no prototype signal model. They're made by a husband and wife team down in the Australian state of Tasmania, the Apple Isle, and they're all brass, and they're just a generic signal based off loosely off an Australian signal. So I like to support this company. They do a great little job, and they just make generic stuff, but it's all brass, all handmade, and they actually polish the LEDs, turn them down and polish the LEDs to get a nice bright sparkling aspect. So I'll be mixing these and more prototype signals on the layout in the future. We're passing the cliffs at the Tarragindi cutoff now. This is my first attempt at modelling a large rock wall, and I used too many small rock moulds. Not really happy with is too complicated, so trying to get some bigger, larger rocks in there to take the sameness out of it, but it was okay for a first attempt. Thank you. As the sun sets, we finally enter West Birdwood Yard after our trip around the lower level of the layout. The sun's about to set at West Birdwood Yard, so thanks for joining us on this grain train cab ride. Hooray for now, and thanks for watching.